Hi everybody, and welcome to the third instalment on the geology of Donegal. In particular, we're talking about sandstone that was laid down nearly 350 million years ago. Now, I'm in a very special place in the south of Donegal. It's a privately run quarry called Drumkeelan Quarry, and it contains the famous Mountcharles Sandstone. Now, this is a large boulder from a very, very good vein of the material just behind me here that's been recently quarried out, and you can see that beautiful light sandy colour that the rock has to offer. It's extremely good for sculptors and for building with, because it comes away in relatively uniform blocks, and it can also be carved into basically any shape you want. You could put your face into that stone if you liked. Now, this material was laid down here as part of a sedimentation process on a gigantic river delta on the edge of an ancient continent that used to exist in what is now southern Donegal. We have the luck in Donegal of being able to say that we have virtually every rock type here and have evidence of almost every process that you now see happening in physical geography around the world on a global scale. We have the evidence of it all here. This bed represents a period of advanced deposition for a very large river, something on the order of the River Nile today, depositing huge tracts of sand, in some cases mud and coarser sands, as it flowed into an ancient ocean that's now closed up, that these rocks used to form the bed of. Behind me, you can take a look at the differing layers, the differing thicknesses in particular, in the layers of the sandstone behind me. And they indicate different times in the life of the river where sea level may have changed or the amount of water entering the river may have changed. In other words, they are a book that you can read that is based on the climate at the time the sandstones were being formed, almost 400 million years ago. Truly ancient rocks. Now, the big beds indicate a lot of deposition. So a very fast flowing river with plenty of rock coming into it at its head and then flowing down, getting churned up, turned into sand and then deposited onto this delta. The next several layers down represent fluctuations in the climate, more rainfall upstream, less rainfall upstream. The result being more and less rock getting deposited consecutively until you reach a time where you get boulders like this being deposited, where there's an awful lot of rain coming down upstream, there's an awful lot of fast flowing water, very thick deposition happening. Now, that's the general rule when you're looking at sandstone layers, particularly like these ones here. Not all sandstones are a form of river deposition. Some of them actually occur at the bottom of oceans as well, when material on the continental shelf slips off and forms new layers of rock. They're called turbidity currents. But by and large, if you're looking for a perfect textbook example of what sandstone looks like and how it occurs naturally, or in this case here in the quarry environment where you can really see the layers, this, you'll get no better than this. So in the next clip, we'll show you some of the different layering and show you some of the minerals that are in those layers as well, to help you pick out what you're looking at and some of the features of the rock as well, to help you pick out in particular whether you're looking at the top of the bed of sandstone or the bottom of the bed of sandstone. We find a lovely example here of the top of a sandstone bed that used to exist at the bottom of that delta we were talking about earlier on, being continuously deposited with layers of sandstone and layers of mudstone as the river changed with climate over time. The surface of this boulder that I'm sitting on here is a record, a snapshot from a period in time 300 million years ago when this was actually the bottom of a shallow sea. You're looking at maybe 30 meters, 40 meters water depth, with the river depositing large layers of more sand over this sporadically. What you end up with is this fossilized seafloor that you can look at and trace what happened on the day of its formation. For example, there are a few places here where we can see ripples where the water, probably tidal waters, were coming in over this, pushing the sand up and down along the surface, much as you would see at the beach today with the rising and lowering of the tides. We've also got some tiny little trackways in this, and this hollow worm-like shape here, probably as a result of some animal scurrying across the surface of this while it was being laid down. But again, the reason why this exists is because that fast-flowing, very heavily depositing river quickly covered this up. So this is really a day in the life of the formation of the sandstone, encapsulated here on the top of this boulder. Like I said in the previous video about quartzite, you need to know how to define the top of a bed of any rock and the bottom of it. And for sandstone, it's relatively easy. If you're looking at these features, if they're staring you in the face, the rock is the right way up. It's the way it was on the surface when it was formed. Now this is hard when you're looking at boulders. We have the advantage of this being in a quarry here, so it's easy enough. But if you find this out on the side of a hill, on the side of a mountain where glaciation has moved the boulder away from its original position, you can quickly tell with these features its top or its bottom bed. So in the next little clip, I want to show you some of the mineralization that happens, and to do that we'll go up back up to the rock face that was behind me a few minutes
ago. Back at the rear of the quarry now, up close and personal with the face of the rock. And just to give you an example of changes in rate of deposition, I have a wonderful one of it here. We've got a beautifully even-grained sandstone here, albeit a very small layer. Then a sudden dark layer that flakes away, comes away as this brown material. It's a layer of mudstone. That's evidence of a river slowly coming to a halt and depositing nothing that's a too big a grain size like the sand. In other words, the weather changed. Now that could have resulted in a change in sea level or a change in the amount of water coming down the river. Either way though, it's what has given you this unique bedding in the sandstone. The river then in a few thousand or maybe even a few million years kicks off again and deposits a very coarse grained layer. And I'm going to pick out a piece of that and show you to the camera. All those coarse grains mean fast flowing water. It's not sifting it too well, it's just throwing everything in together. In other words, the climate kicked off again and moved very, very fast. Now, as you look at all of the layers of the sandstone here, you're looking at this book that you can read all of these events from. And understanding what you're looking at will allow you to appreciate better the type of rock that is around you in particular. That's why we're making these videos, so that you understand and know what you're looking at, because that, I've always found, adds to the wonder of it all. So that's a little bit about sandstone, and in particular we're using a very fine example of sandstone in South Donegal here. There are other sedimentary rocks such as limestone as well, which we won't go into just now. We'll save those for the physical geography part of it, because there's a few places in Donegal that have good examples of it. But for now, that's the conclusion to this one. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you found it very informative, and I hope it gives you a greater enjoyment of the rocks and the physical environment that you're looking at when you're out having a ramble. Thank you very much, and I'll talk to you again soon.